Think of the long necks you have in your diamond press. I still want to see those. And in, exhale. In, exhale. In, exhale. In, last set. In, exhale. In, and fabulous job. Now, straighten your arms out. Keep your legs lifted. Lift the arms, draw them out to the side. Take them down by your sides. Squeeze the inner thighs together so your legs go into a little external rotation. And we're going to do a da and hold it for 5 counts. Press your pubic bone to the floor, lengthen the back of your neck. Reach your arms downwards away from your head and towards your spine. 4, 3, 2, 1. Arms to the side, arms to the front. Turn your legs to parallel for a set of swimming. Alternate arm leg reach for 10, 9, 8, 7, 6, 5. Lift from the back of your knees. 2, 1. One arm, one leg down. One arm, one leg down. Hands by your chest. Lift up. Tuck your tail under. And come back to a well-deserved child's pose. Hold that for 10 or so counts. It's really nice to just stretch out the back after we've extended it a bit. We're going to come back onto our sides, but we will come back to do double leg kick later, so we're not off the hook completely. So turning around so that you have your left leg on top and lie down so you're resting on your bicep, the opposite arm. We're going to do our clam exercise. So pressing the weight down on the top foot to the bottom foot. Your top hip is vertically stacked on top of the bottom. And if you think about your two sit bones reaching down towards your heels, you'll find that your waist lifts off the floor. And that's what we want. We want that little mouse hole gap there. And you can do, we're going to do 8 clams. You can do them with your hand on your hip, or you can do them with your hand there. I think all of you have got pretty good balance, so I'd be erring on the side of hand on hip. And if you want a little more challenge, you can put your hand up. Because I'm looking for that absolute stillness through the top and the bottom hip. Yeah, that's lovely. And can everybody feel it now working in those deep rotators? I can. Yep, I'm getting some positive vibes there. And 3, 2, 1. Hold it there. We're going to lift it up and turn the leg in so the knees touch and the toe doesn't. Now the toes touch and the knee doesn't. And knee, foot, knee, foot, knee, foot, knee, foot. Last one, knee, foot. Now keep your foot there. Don't move the position of your thigh or your knee, but take your foot and your lower leg away from the floor and lift them up until they're parallel. And if you take a look at your foot, if anything, your heel is a little bit higher than your knee. Not much, you're aiming for parallel, but just as a guide, it's just above. And we're going to do open and closes. So inhale is the close. Make sure you still have that vertical stack. And inhale. Exhale up, inhale down. Exhale and lengthen through the thigh and the knee. And lower. Exhale, lengthen. Inhale, lower. So let's all be very careful we don't let the leg turn out. It's, if anything, turned in a bit because we're trying to work the smaller gluteal muscles here. And they won't work if we let the external ones take over. So exhale up. Yeah, that's better, everyone. And down. Exhale up. And down. and up, and down, and hold it up. And we're going to take that leg slightly back, and you'll feel, if you put your hand on your butt, that your glute max fires a little more strongly. And then we bring it forward till it's 90 degrees of flexion at the front, endeavoring not to move this part of our body. And then we take it back, almost like you want to kick yourself in the bottom. And inhale forward, exhale back. Inhale forward, so it's a good stability exercise for your pelvis when it's in this side lying position. And forward, and back, and forward, and back, and forward. Last one after this. And forward, and back. Bring it back to the side. We're going to roll onto our back for one leg circle. So the way we do it is we're going to straighten that top leg, draw a semicircle up to the ceiling, hands by your side, bend up the other leg, and move yourself so you're into the center of your mat, and slide that leg down. And so you'll flex the leg that's on the floor, which is your right leg, and you point the toe that's up to the ceiling. Now let's check in with our shoulders. You want to put your shoulder blades a little firmly into the mat, and you want to press the backs of your shoulders into the mat, and your hands down, not necessarily right by your sides, they can be a little bit away from center, because that'll help stabilize you. We're going to breathe in as we cross that left leg over the midline, then circle down and around. Inhale across, exhale, circle down and around. Inhale, exhale, circle. So you're only going as big as your pelvis can maintain its stability. It's not so much a rock and roll, it's a nice, luscious circle of the leg in the air in the hip joint. Let's go the other way. So it's inhale, take the leg away from the body, exhale, circle down and around. Inhale away, exhale, circle around. Inhale away, exhale, circle, two more. If it's getting a little tiring to have your legs straight, you can always bend your leg a little bit, shortening the lever. Good job. Now let's bend that leg to tabletop. Keep it there. Slide the leg in that's on the floor. Inhale and exhale, float it to tabletop. And place the leg that was in the air down to the floor as we straighten up the right leg to the ceiling. Slide the left leg down along the mat and flex the foot. And the other thing to keep in mind here is while we do the circles, press that left hamstring down into the mat, pointing up the right toe as much as you can to the ceiling. Inhale, cross the leg over your body. Exhale, circle around. I'm very pleased to see those of you that need to protect your hamstrings are doing so. Good job. And around. Inhale, cross the body. Exhale, circle around. Big breaths. Inhale, exhale, inhale, exhale. Other way, we go inhale away from the body, exhale, circle down and around. Inhale, exhale, whip it around. Press that left hamstring down into the mat. And three more. And two more. Big engagement of the abdominals. And leave that leg there. Float up your left leg to tabletop. And you're going to lower that right leg to 6 inches off the floor, placing your right hand on the top of your left knee and pull your head and shoulders off the mat. And take your left hand and place it on top of your left ankle. Four, single leg stretch. So breathe in, and as you exhale, swap to the other leg and hand grip. Inhale, bend the knees. Exhale, straighten out one leg. Inhale, exhale, swap. Inhale, exhale, swap. Inhale, exhale, swap. And that's the way. Now we've got the form happening, we can go a little faster for 10. Ready? And on one. to go into some crisscross now, get our obliques firing up. So we're going to place the hands into a little interlaced position and then place them behind the head. We're going to start with the left leg going out and the right leg is bent. Therefore, we rotate to our right leg. So we're rotating to the bent leg. Inhale through center, two legs in tabletop, and then rotate to the other side. And in. Exhale, rotate. Inhale. Exhale, rotate. Straighten out that leg, everyone. Get it a little straighter. Reach, reach, reach. And in. And a reach. Ready for your 10 in double time. And up. 1 and 2 and 3 and 4. 9, 10, legs in, roll up. Yeah, pretty damn good job. Okay, let's massage out through the spine and have some fun with seal puppy. So it's a rolling exercise that is designed to massage the lumbar spine, but also to work deeply in your abdominals. So you're going to have a hand grip where your hands come underneath your legs and you pick them up. The toes, your feet, soles of your feet go together. So this exercise has its name based on your doing a little slap of your fins like a seal does. And we do three in the sitting up position and we do three in the rolling back. So I'm pretty sure all of you know how to do this, so we'll just get stuck into it. And know that the inhalation is the going back, and the exhalation with the deep abdominal contraction is what gets you coming all the way up. Remember, when you go back, try and get your tailbone to reach to the ceiling, like you're doing, almost like you're starting a pelvic curl to bridge. So let's breathe in and don't move. Breathe out and curl. And lift the legs. Breathe in and roll back. Clap, two, three. Up, two, three. Inhale. Exhale. Inhale. Exhale. Inhale. Exhale. And two more. Keep going. There's a whole seal colony in my studio. It's looking pretty good. And last one to come up to sitting. Ah, very nice. Okay, we're going to go on to our other side because I've given you enough time to forget about the pain in your left glutes for us to come and do the other side. So you're going to lie down into your clam position, resting on your biceps, knees bent where your heels are in line with your bottom, and making sure that you've lengthened through your sit bones so they're reaching towards your heels so that your top hip is stacked on the bottom and we've got that little gap between the waist and the mat. Take a breath in to prepare. Exhale, press the top leg down onto the bottom and lower, with your choice being arm to the ceiling, arm to the hip, or to the floor. And lower. Exhale, lengthen through the thigh, and inhale, lower. Exhale and open. Inhale and lower. Exhale and open. Inhale and lower. Exhale and open. And lower. Two more. Exhale and in. Really draw the abdominals in and expand the ribs like we did in the beginning of class. Now open up, stay there, and we do our internals. So inhale and exhale. In for the knee, out for the foot. In for the knee, out for the foot. In for the knee, out for the foot, and in and out. We still draw the abdominals in. one in and hold that there. Then we take the lower leg away and bring it so that both legs are parallel to each other. Just having a little look to see that your heel slightly higher than the knee. And we inhale and lower the leg down. Try and get the toes and the knees to touch down at the same time. Exhale, lift, and we're trying to lengthen this thigh away and in. That's it, nice work guys. And in and down. You can always put this lower leg having a little bit of pressure into the floor. Just helps you work your waistline a bit and engage the adductors of the underneath leg. You know, we're always about efficiency of movements. And exhale up. Check that you don't have any tension in your neck. And up. And lower. And up. Lengthen it away. And we have three more of these to go. Exhale up. Inhale down. Exhale. Last one. And hold it up. Ready for our forwards and back. So inhale is forward, leg to 90 degrees. Exhale, take it back. Check that your glutes are working, but you're still drawing your abdominals in because you don't want to take your back into an arch. Inhale and exhale. Inhale and exhale. It really impresses me to see so many pelvises staying still because that's a challenge. Because I could just do a really big movement like this, but then I've lost all the stability and hard work for maintaining that. Inhale forward, exhale back. Inhale forward, exhale back. Two more. Inhale and exhale. Inhale and exhale. Now straighten that leg on top back and reach it back and reach your top arm forward and straighten out the arm that's on the bottom of the floor. Reach, reach, reach. And then you're going to roll, take that leg that's on top so far back, it rolls you onto your back like a starfish. Now let's reach out through both bottom legs. Both limbs reach down, your tailbone reaches away, and your fingers of both arms reach up, and your head reaches up. Now this one, you're going to have to trust me a little bit on that my instructions are clear enough, because I want you to, the arm that was on the floor to start with, which I think was your left arm, you're going to reach it up overhead, reach it to take you to the other side, and then you'll reach that left leg back, reach, 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 to bring you to the other side for that stretch. And then you come back to your starfish and reach to the other side, starfish, and reach, and starfish. It's a stretch, so don't get caught in the brain work of it. Allow your body to take you where it needs to. It's just stretch. Feel the connection between your upper and lower bodies. One side connecting to the opposite of the other. So big stretch through arm, legs, through the center. And you can lift the leg that's off the floor as high as you can to get the stretch that you want, but don't let it get into your back to any pain. It should feel lovely. And then I want you to roll back into your starfish. And we're going to use this as a way to curl back. So you bring your elbows together, bring your knees together, and curl up into a ball. So your two elbows meet your legs, and then you're going to go out to your starfish. Exhale, draw everything into center. And then tuck your legs down and open your legs. Exhale, bring everything to center. And touch down and expand. That's the inhale. Exhale, draw down and in. Heads up and down. And I'm using this as a practice for the harder exercise we'll do next week, our double leg stretch. So this is a nice little precursor to it. So draw in and curl and legs down and arms out. And last one, and in, stay there. Put your hands on top of your knees and bring your knees a little closer and do a little rock, 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 rock. And we're going to use it to do a little bit of momentum to eventually get you up to sitting. And we did it. We all got there. Yay! So let's just do a little rock and roll. Just going to do a little cool down. So taking your butt over to one side and the other. Actually push down your legs. They come up, they come down. So just exercising through those obliques, a little internal obliques. Push, push, push. Let your head go. Rock and roll, rock and roll. Well, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. And we're back to where we started at the beginning of class. Let's reach our arms out to the side. As long as you can get them. Longer. Longer, longer. Take another breath in there. Take your arms up to the ceiling. Expansion through all lobes of the lungs. And exhale, draw the hands down. A little pressure into the palms of your hands. A little tap, inhale. And thank you all for coming. You did a fantastic job.